Good evening, everybody, and welcome to Dark DJ Productions. And today on A Dark Drives Tries Live Thingy Bob, we're going to be looking at this, as you probably already knew from the thumbnail. So, today we're going to be having a look at this. This is the Northeastern Railway Worsdell H-Class, better known as the LNER Y7 040 tank engine, brought to Train Simulator by Wayside Works. Yes, this is the first time in a very long time that I have driven and looked at a Wayside Works locomotive, because the improvements I've seen from this guy starting out in Train Sim to this point is quite astronomical. So I only thought it right to do some justice by the developer and show a little bit of this. Now, this is a freeware locomotive. You can download this for free on Wayside Works' website. Link is in the description. And if you want to, because obviously all this stuff is free, if you want to help him out a bit, then you can donate via his website, via PayPal. But I just wanted to put that out there, that this stuff is, you know, there's a lot to look at. There's a lot of industrials. But today I'm just going to focus on the Y7 and show you a few of the variants, do a bit of shunting and do a little trip working, and just have a genuine little look at it. I'm quite excited because the Y7 is actually a little loco that I've sort of liked for a very long time. I used to have this thing all the way back in MFTS days, and quite honestly, it's nice to see it finally represented in Train Sim after all these years. So, a bit of history, not really going to do much in the history. I haven't really researched the history of the Y7, to be perfectly honest. All I know is that they were designed by Worsdell. I think only a handful of them were built, and they were basically built for shunting in dockyards and areas with, you know, tight curvature. And I believe only two survived through the war into early British Railways days, but they were withdrawn. I know that this one, the preserved number 1310, because they're two preserved, 1310 and 985, 98 something, 8088, basically. There were two preserved. This one was sold into the National Coal Board, of which actually Wayside Works has actually represented that in this pack. And it survived into preservation and was redone up like this as Northeastern Railway number 1310. So I haven't put all the variants down, but we will have a look at some of them, and we'll drive another one later on. So we're going to be driving this one. This is the Northeastern Railway and preserved number 1310. My lighting might not give it all that justice, but it's quite well textured, especially, again, you've got to bear in mind that it is free to use. Doesn't require anything to run it, just Train Sim. And as you can see next to it is the quite pretty Northeastern Railway lined black. So there's another variation for you. They also have two different types of whistles. One of them is I call it a teapot whistle. And the other one is a hooter, which was on the later versions. So you've also got the NER one there. You've got the LNER version here. Each one also comes with a version with the vac brakes or no vac brakes, but they've both got the steam brakes, so that's good for shunting. You've also got weathered versions of each one. So this one is the wartime Northeastern Railway livery. There's also this one, which is NCB condition for number 1310, which was numbered 64 by the NCB. And it had a cut-down chimney and a cut-down safety valve. And you can really see the difference between them. It really is a pretty big difference, actually, when you look at them side by side, these two particularly, because you can see, like, just cutting down the chimney and cutting down the safety valve really changes the profile of the engine. And then the final one I've got sat here is this one, which is a fictional maroon livery, so that's kind of pleasant. I think the only thing I'd have maybe suggested was maybe British Railways, but I say that, it's not here, but there is a British Railways one, and I will show you guys in a little while. So, without further ado, I'm going to unpause the game, and we're going to do some shunting with this one, so number 1310. So, what I'm going to do is show you around the cab first. So, here's the side of the inside of the cab. You've got the whistle cord is up there. which is quillable, which is nice. I just put duck on. Whoops. So let's see what we've got down here. You've got the reverser there. Obviously, the regulator's in the middle here. And you've also got opening windows. Oh, it's clipping through me, but that's because of my camera view. So you can open up these front windows at least. And I would say you can open the back windows, but I think it's pretty open, wouldn't you say? So what cab views do you get? So you start with this one. You've got one out of the side of the window here. You've got another one out of this side. You've got one out of this side of the loco, and then you've got one down by the wheels on this side, and one by down the wheels on this side. Unfortunately, you can't move some of these cameras. This one in particular, you can't move, but I think there was difficulty with scripting that. But it doesn't matter. You can move these ones, and that's the ones that are important for shunting and whatnot. So, let's set ourselves up. I know what I want to do. I've set up on Scotch Racetrack. We're in the north of the map, and what we're going to do is a little bit of shunting, probably move some wagons around and whatnot, and then I'm going to take some coal wagons that are here, and I'm going to take them over here to this yard. We're going to swap over to a different loco over here, which is the aforementioned British Railways one, and we'll bring it back down to the coal stage. But first and foremost, let's go and do some shunting. So that means I actually need to set myself a path, does it not? So we can have a look at the sounds, and we can have a look at what it looks like on the move, because there's a lot to like, especially considering that, again, I'm going to keep saying it, it is free to use, and, you know, we do like a bit of free to use locos, especially because a lot of people haven't got the budget to be buying lots of other locos a lot of the time. So this is a nice little thing to just try, and there's a lot of other industrials, actually, that Wayside Works has made, so they're worth looking at too. Let's see, where do I want to go? It's alright, very difficult to see the blue lines on this. I want to go over here, because there's a couple of wagons we want to do a little bit of shunting with. Because this engine is basically perfect for this layout. You know, doing a little bit of dock shunting and whatnot. I think it'll path us that way. So let's find out. Let's go out the cab. The other nice thing is that you can see that the windows have changed as I put them in the cab. So it's obviously 3D modelled in and out. You've also got, the best thing I think about this loco is things like the valve gear. All the valve gear inside is animated. You can see it quite well because of how high up the boiler is. And you'll see as well, if I open the cylinder cocks and get the loco into running, if I can get it to work, there we go. And I think I've got cylinder cocks open, yep. And you've also got, you can press the V key for a short whistle on these. And it changes the thing as you're moving along. So it's also got steam check, which is pleasant. There we go. And you can also see something I enjoy is, because you can see there through the frames, all the valve gear. Doesn't that look nice? I've enjoyed watching that all the time that I've been driving this. And I've only been driving it for a day. But you can also see, if you look in there, see all that lovely valve gear moving. I think it's joy valve gear, actually. So that's even more impressive. But the other thing is, you can see the... it's better at slow speed, but you can see, like, the particle effects inside the frames. And they sort of alternate between each piston. You'll see it a bit better as we're going along. You can also change the lamps. I think it's shift 1, 2 and 3 on this one. That's all for all three of the front lamps. And then I think it's, yeah, 4 for the rear lamp on 1310. So for the purpose of what we're doing at the moment, I'm going to just run with, let's say, not the top lamp. Let's run with that side lamp there. So as I say, I have put a lot of... wagons and stuff to shunt. I don't think I'm going to shunt all of them, but I have been using this scenario just to shunt around with the Y7s. Lovely little thing, isn't it? There you go, there's a slightly longer whistle there. So yeah, if you've got any sort of dockyards you want to run this thing on, it's got the perfect wheelbase, perfect size. It might not be the most powerful engine in the world, but I'm going to say it, and I don't really care if I sound controversial, because I haven't particularly driven that much of Wayside Works' stuff. But this, I believe, I mean, this is freeware. I believe this is up there with payware quality. I've had this discussion before, and you can clearly see that this is done for the passion of doing it and for the want of doing it, rather than strictly meeting a deadline of any sort. So that is something I can definitely appreciate with this. Just go back on this side for a minute and have a look in here. Got the pressure gauges, not sure if they actually work. I think the boiler pressure one probably does. I'm not sure about the vacuum brake one. Yep, the vacuum brake one does work. And I'll have to find out about the boiler pressure one as we go along. But anyway, my point being is that this... he releases this for free. But I think it's up there with payware quality, especially for the size of logo. I think it's good. We've got the handbrake. Oh, I forgot that the handbrake actually animates. That's nice. Ooh, nearly smacked myself in the head with that. I'm hoping I'm actually going the right way for what I wanted to do. Fingers crossed. I will have a look at the comment section in a bit. But I know I'm giving this lots... the only things I can really... I don't even really think I can criticise that much, to be perfectly honest with you. It's just sort of a nice little shunting engine. I think, here we go, we're heading up to where I think we're going, which is we're going to pick up some wagons from... Yeah, we're going to pick them up. So we use the steam brake, which are very powerful, by the way, and use the square bracket keys for this. I guess the only thing is that this doesn't have a reverser lock simulated, but some of Wayside Works' other stuff has got a reverser lock simulated, but I'm not criticising that because that's making shunting a lot easier. So that doesn't bother me, to be perfectly honest. Still a shot from down here. Where are we going to go next? We want to put these in front of... If I remember what I'm doing on my practice runs, I'd like to put this on front of a brake van, which is in that siding there. So let's do that. Brakes off, forward gear, little hoot to say we're going. So you can probably imagine that my impression already is that I'm quite enjoying this. And as of my friends I've been talking to this afternoon, we were saying this, which is that it's nice to have a little free loco, because one of my friends has only just gotten into train sim stuff, my mate Arthur, and he hasn't got a lot at the moment, and he's only just got this thing to work, and it's just nice to have something little and free that's of this sort of quality, because it's sort of a stepping stone, I'd say, into future DLC purchases from other developers, or even just downloading from the same developer who made this sort of dealio. I don't know how far forward I've got to go. So, it's nice to have that kind of thing. If that makes any sense whatsoever. It made sense in my head when I said it. I think I've actually gone way too far. It made sense in my head. But whether it makes sense to the audience, I do not know. It's just a nice loco. The only thing I could say would have been nice on this is if I could have switched the camera around from this view to look backward, which is a shame, but it you know, this guy is doing this all for free, and it's all still a good learning curve as well. This guy's been learning and getting better and better with help from other people, so I'm not surprised. I think it's still perfectly serviceable, considering that some other freeware that we've seen in the past has been sort of questionable. And now I think you can see what I mean about the valve chests. You can see as each piston moves, a separate steam emission happens from underneath the smoke box. That is really nice. Pleasant. And pleasant, just a nice little loco to drive. Don't think you could run this on an express. And why would you want to? So we'll pop this on the front of the brake van, because what I'm going to do is we're going to take this we're going to set up a little train, take it back to the other end, set up a train at the other end, bring it back down here. And then I think we'll take the coal train over to the other side, because we've got another dock on the other side that we're going to go and pick up some stuff from. Because I think what it is we're going to be taking loaded coal over to the other side of the harbour, and then we're going to bring back some empties back to the coal barge. Right, I think we're coupled up to the brake van. Let's have a look. Yep. So, seam brake on a second. If I go into here and put the handbrake on for there, uncouple. And then we'll add a few more wagons, I think. Also, if you're wondering why I chose to drive this one, one, it's in the thumbnail, and two, I think if anybody thinks of a Y7, you're more than likely going to think of 1310. We don't really hear much about the other one, which is why I can't even remember what his number is. I think it's BR number was 68088. But you can see on the sharpness of these curves why this is such a decent engine for dock shunting. Because obviously smaller radius curves means smaller radius loco needed. Does take off like a little rocket though if you put it right in. It does slip as well, I found. Sorry, I didn't mean to say it like that. I found that it slips quite well, even on sort of dry rail. Which is interesting because it's such a small locomotive and it's so light that it's going to slip. Right, easy does it. Easy does it. We top it up? Yes, look at that. Right, brakes off. And I think this is also the first of what I would call the big company locos that Wayside Works has done. The only other one I would kind of say, because obviously he's done Peckett's, Barclays, and Huswell Clark's, is Bay of Peacock, which is the Ilfracombe Goods. Now, I haven't forgotten about that one, because there's a very impressive feature on that that I really like, which is that the smoke particle bounce off of tunnels and things. But I wanted to run that as a separate stream on the Ilfracombe branch. Obviously, it's not going to be very good because the Ilfracombe line is incredibly steep. But it's the Ilfracombe goods. It would have worked on the Ilfracombe branch for the London and South Western Railway. So technically, does that count? I think it does count. But this one is... It's difficult to describe. I think this is because this is a North Eastern Railway locomotive. So it kind of makes sense that this would be like the bigger one, which is interesting because it's a small one, but I digress. So let's go and couple this up to back to our wagons that we put up earlier. And I'm going to have to drive out of the cab for this bit because I don't want to crash this early on. And then I will actually have a look at what people are saying in the comment section. I hope people are enjoying this actually, because I don't shunt very often. It's not very often I kind of do these shunting scenarios, because usually I just sort of get in an engine and then I just start driving it. But today we're actually doing something a bit more, you know, I would say brain powery, but as most people know, I haven't really got a brain. I just exist out of pure spite, because I'm evil. But even I could admit, when somebody does something and they improve, you've got to give them credit for it. And this is what I intend to do. I want to give Wayside Works the credit they deserve for actually going forward and improving their work. Which is very much appreciated, I must say, because I've been using quite a few of their locos on for other things. And there we go, we're connected up. So I think this is probably long enough for us to take back to the other side of the line, back to the other side of the docks even. So I think we've got a path right back up there. Train's probably a bit long for where I was thinking about putting it. Actually, no, you know what, we will. We're going to go and put it in that siding over there and then we'll pick another one up. So for this bit, I think what I'll do is I will come out of the cab view. Let me get the brakes off. Open the cylinder cocks. And we shall use my Xbox camera to watch it depart from this particular area. So, should I turn the sounds up a little bit? Yeah, I think I'll turn the sounds up a little bit for this bit. So, sounds going up, me going a little bit quiet for a minute, and we shall see. I might have a look at the comment section in a minute as well while we're on the way back over the other side. Here we go. Just remember that I haven't taken the handbrake off. That might be a good idea, mightn't it? There we go. By the way, I have to thank James, by the way, as in my mate James Superior, for the suggestion, not only for doing this run that I'm going to do in a minute, but also for moderating the chat tonight. So, cheers, mate. I'm appreciating that. Bring it to a nice controlled stop. And undo handbrake, reverser, and then just make sure. I don't know why the map keeps pulling me out of where I am. We want to make sure that we're going to go into the siding I'd like to go into, which is that one. No, don't roll forward, you silly engine. We're going backwards, thank you. And we'll stand in the brake van for this bit so we can make sure that we don't crash through the buffers and end the scenario. Otherwise, that will have been however long I've been doing this ruined. So, looking at the comments as well, I'm learning some new information. Mainly the fact that one of the examples, the preserved example, the other one, number 985, is a Darlington built example. I'm not sure whether that means this one's a Gateshead. Is it Gateshead, the other one? Example? Someone will tell me, and I'm sure somebody will tell me somewhere in the comments. But at least there's that little bit of variety, which I'm enjoying greatly. I think I'll be keeping this scenario just for this sort of thing in the future. probably afford to go back a little bit more. And bump. He's only gone and done it. Look at that. Perfect shunting. No problems whatsoever. So then, what needs to be moved elsewhere? Well, I could take those oil tankers somewhere. Or, what was over here? I've got to remember what was over here. We had a couple of random coal wagons there, but we don't want them, even though they'd be more convenient. Is there anything in the station here? There's some cattle wagons. So actually, there's an idea. I know what I can do, because that train is obviously waiting to leave. It hasn't got a brake van attached to it. But what I could do... is there a brake van over here? Yes, there is. I has idea of something I can do. So what we're going to do, jump back to our engine. We're going to take these cattle wagons, pull them out, run round them, I think, if I can do that. Let me just see if I'm disconnected from my train. Yep. So, I undo the brakes. It's kind of relaxing just shunting. No. God, it just took off like a little rocket then, didn't it? Look at that. Meow. So, if Yaren happened to be watching this, who is Wayside Works, by the way, Super Y7, when? That would be interesting. Right. Over here. Perfect. Now, the next question is there somewhere I can run around these? I could. Yeah, I can see where I can go. So if I... Because if that's there, I want to be able to go that way. So if I switch the points here, and then switch these points there. No. That way. Yeah. And then I go into that loop there. Yes, then I can run around. Yeah, I know what I'm doing. Let's go move these cattle. It really is a little pocket rocket, this thing. God, just look at that valve gear. The fact you can see it all through the frames as well is really nice. Chilly in it. Bit drafty. Might need to put some water in a minute. Not verified right from the camber loco either. This is very interesting. What is wrong with me? Crossing gates. Hello. That one's closed, but why haven't you opened? Okay. I think I might need to move the train back a little bit, though. Yes, I left it a little bit late for braking. And it might be because I haven't set the points properly, so we'll double check that. I love that as well. Opening the cylinder cock drains the steam chest, which I'm not sure if that's completely realistic, but it's handy. That might be why. Change those points and change those points. There you go. Look at that. The crossing gates are open now. So if I press G, I want to see if this... Does it close them up? Yeah, look at that. Awesome. See? This is also why I like using Glenet Creation stuff. They're pretty good too. They're very pog. So if I jump back in the cab, should we do the injectors? You need some coal? Yeah, I could probably do some coal. Wait for the crossing to move. I'm having a ridiculously enjoyable time shunting. Why don't I shunt more often? Probably because I'm scared I'm going to cock it all up, and I probably still will. There is still time, yeah. But I'm hoping I've shown you guys enough of the Y7 if you like it. I want to get round to the BR one, though, because it has the other whistle, and I wanted to show you guys the alternate whistle. Right. That's the point to change in that direction. Again, the camp. I don't know why the map keeps doing that to me. It's really frustrating. I know it means a bit of a long run round, but we've now got to run all the way back there. Why is it not sending me through where I think it's supposed to be sending me through? Ah, I see why. Didn't change that point. Not that one. So there we go. We can run back down there. We also need to make sure that we're not going to go in there later. So let's go. And I think I'll show off the valve gear again, because I'm sorry, I love the valve gear. It's great. I wish I could get in there more. Move the camera around there, you can see it all working in there. Lovely. Of course, you probably have to make sure it's all animated, because it's very visible, this valve gear. Oh, I've overfilled a bit. Kind of mesmerizing. This is why people like steam engines. It's this sort of mechanics, I think. The mechanics of it is just, you know, it's hard to explain, but I hope you know what I mean. Watching the mechanical bits doing their thing and realizing that really this is just a big kettle on wheels with a few bits of machinery strapped to it. It's kind of mind-boggling. Stops on a dime. Very good. And now we should be able to, if the map behaves itself, switch back to that line, which means we should be able to go straight up to the wagons that we dropped off a minute ago. Oh, wait, no. No, we don't want to do that, do we? We want to grab the wagons that are over here first. So can I manoeuvre myself over there? I can. So if we go there, I think it actually takes us into that siding. Cool, let's go. Because then we connect the whole thing, couple it all up, and then we'll go do our coal run, because I've already been doing this for half an hour, more than half an hour. I didn't think I'd be doing this for this long. That's how much I'm just enjoying shunting. I'm very sorry, this has basically become Dark tries the Y7 and then gets distracted by doing lots of shunting. I hope no one complains about that. Let's take the lamp and change it. Oh, hang on, that one I want. Sorry, I'm looking at the valve gear again, sorry. Yeah, I've got a lot of grunt for such a small engine, I must admit. Sorry about the sparks as well. When you put it in 100% reg, it sparks. I don't know if I managed to show the wheel slip yet. Maybe I'll show it in a minute. Oh, it's such a dinky little thing. I love it. Maybe I'll be able to slip it in a second. Let's find out. Obviously slip it in reverse. There you go. Oh, silly thing. Stop. Steam chef to die. There we go. It was about to run away from me, and I need to switch points again. There's that one. Let's go collect the rest of the cattle wagons. See, when Yaren does a bigger tender engine with a bit more power, I can redo this scenario, but use another one of the Wayside Works larger engines in order to do the shunt and then have the engine take it away. I'd use the Ilfracombe goods, but I just don't think it's got the power. But maybe I'm wrong. I don't know. Like, easy does it. Easy does it. Remember, we've got cows in here. Don't want to upset the cows or they might moo at us or something. Oh, look, it just has... Oh, it's just got so little weight on its wheels. And this is where we need to... I think that's the switch back there. Yeah. So everyone, I'm really enjoying myself tonight. I didn't think I'm going to enjoy this much. Shunting is not usually my forte. Right, there we go. Stop! Brakes! I said brakes! While it's deciding whether we're going to stop, let's go find the path to the brake van, which is in there. Now, I understand this is probably not the way to do things, because I could slam into that brake van and destroy the whole universe, but could be fun. We'll try. And then we've got to do is shunt this train into the goods platform that we had the train originally in. That's ready for another engine to take out later, so I can see myself setting up so I can do some trip working between this side of the harbour and the other. When I'm not doing a dedicated review, because at the moment I'm hoping I'm doing justice for the Y7. It's even better later on, we get to drive the BR version. Ooh. Brakes. God, these steam brakes are very powerful. And there we go. We has brake van. So now we have a full length train. No, I'm not taking this up and over the bridge. It is, this engine is way not powerful enough for that. She's good for shunting. Maybe a few little trip working, but not for a train this length. By the way, I'm purposely slipping it for fun, by the way. Thanks, brake fan. I think, yeah, we can stop now. quite immersive on these wagons. Are they not? Could just be me. Maybe they're not. Maybe they are. Right. I actually think what I'm going to do, to switch this up a little bit, we've been doing this with this little Y7. I'm going to go pick one of the other Y7s to go over to the other side of the harbour. So, I would say let the audience pick. Actually, that's a good idea. I'm going to do that. I'm going to let the audience pick. I'll throw up a poll in a minute. So it's going to basically be NCB, Maroon, or LNER. I'll make it that choice. How's that sound, everyone? Oh, I can't actually move to the other end of the brake van. Well, this is handy, isn't it? I've got a good feeling that people are going to probably say the NCB one. I hope the NCB one. I might just take the NCB one. Because I like the NCB one. But I'm going to use my democracy. Whatever it's called. Whatever the word is. And I'm going to put up the poll in a moment. And I think that'll do. There we go. So, one train successfully shunted. Well done, me. Makes a change. I've done something successful for the first time in my life. So what we'll do, we'll take 1310 back to the shed. While I set up the path ready for us to go back to the shed. I shall quickly put up a poll, if I can, in my YouTube chat. Although, do I have to? Because someone's voted Maroon, NCB, Y7 Cavalcade. Coal Board National. So both, basically, I think people have said they want the NCB one. And for one of the people in the chat have asked what I'm using, it's Scotch Racetrack. Yeah, most people have said NCB. Okay, I shall go with that then. We shall go park this in the shed and we'll use the NCB liveried one. So now I've got to remember which way I'm going. I'm going that way, change that point, change that point. And the NCB one, I think, was there. So we shall put this back where it was originally. I will warn you that the NCB one is essentially just this one, but with the shortening and everything, as in it's still 1310. So I'm going to ask, how has everyone enjoyed the stream so far? Has everyone enjoyed me just shunting with a little tank engine? Has this been entertaining at all so far? I hope so, because even if you guys aren't entertained, I am. And brake on. There we go. And now, and take NCB 1310 out. Same whistle for this one. So it's just a little NCB cutie. So now we've got to do the coal run. So what we shall do is make sure that the points are set in our favour, which I think they are pretty much. And then we want to go down here, back down here. We want to change that set of points for a minute. And then we're going back this way. Yes. And then we want to cross here and here and here. blue line is still going that way, great. And then we'll go to where the coal barge is and we'll pick up our empty wagon to take up the line. Because the frames are green, you can kind of see the valve gear a little bit better. Kind of. And you can see what kind of speeds this thing can get up to, light engine. I like the inclusion of the, like, the windows at the back. You can see where, oh, that was a clip. Bit the character clip through a little bit, but it's okay. You can see where on 1310 they've basically covered over the old gap on the back and they've just basically inserted some rear windows. That's not the real one, this is the real one. Slow down. Down a bit more. So we've essentially got to pick up this train, puff out again, sort of in the triangle formation, reverse back up there, and then we can go forward and across the bridge that was over on the other side, over to the other yard, pick up the BR1, come back, and then I think that'll be Y7's dream over. Actually, this feels more appropriate, taking it in NCB. If we're taking, oh no, these are loaded wagons, that's right, we're taking loaded ones. This should be interesting going back then, because going back, it means we've got to go heavy train up an incline. Interesting. Let's change that point there, because I know I need to change that. That should be fine. And then we should be able to reverse right back up here. And then I think there, we want to cross back over there. Change that point. No, that point. Correct. So we can go forward and up. Because basically, we're going to go up here, across this bridge, and over to this yard over here. So let's go. Let's set up a LAMP code, actually. That'd be good. So shift 4 for this one. And I think it might be time for another one of those famous departing the scene shots. In fact, just for that, I'm going to turn off that. Reverse. Grab my Xbox camera. Sorry, I'm giving this quite a lot of coverage. I don't know why. I think it's just because it's something I'm actually enjoying for a change. And it's different. Weird with a little cut down chimney and cut down safety valve, doesn't it? Bless his little heart. Oh, bit of a rough shunt. Check back with the comments section quickly. Hopefully things are liking it. Nope, someone's saying time to get dirty. Someone hasn't fired up TS for a while. Yeah. Good. I'm glad people are liking it. It's fun. It's a fun little time. And it's all sort of in one of that. And this is definitely a change from just what I would have been, because obviously the Bossman Games school class has come out today, and I will be doing a video on that, maybe tomorrow. Because I'll probably get it set up tonight. I haven't even bought it yet. But I kind of wanted to do this justice first. Because I know a lot of the hype is probably going to be about the school. But I wanted to do the Y7 hype because, you know, it's kind of quirky. A little bit more quirky than you think. And plus, isn't this just such a lovely little machine? It just looks like it's at home here in the docks. Just imagine a fleet of these knocking around in here. Got that big gradient to climb on the right hand side there in a minute. I hope we can do it because I tried this earlier on but with unloaded wagons, so I hope we can do it with loaded ones. I've got to make sure I've got maximum maximum boiler pressure, so maximum effort. We've got maximum fire, thank you very much, Mr. Fireman. A little bit of a roller coaster with this. It's great. Replaces Fear and Otto in TDRS with two Y7s, haha. Certainly more features than the old Hawthorne Leslies, I must say. Right, brakes. Slowly stopping. Which means we can now change that set of points. And then we've got to follow the blue line up here. Yeah, that point needs to change. We're blowing off, so that's good news. We go around this way. And then we go up here, change that point, that point, that point. We go across the bridge. And then I think we're good up to, let's see, the blue line is still there. Up to there for now, so we'll check back on the map when we get to the bridge. So, let's go. This is a fun little bugger to drive around, isn't it? No tail light, uh-oh. Can I put one on? No, can't put one on. Ah, we're inside a building. Get a little bit closer, there we go. I also love how the wagon is almost the same height as the boiler, or is the same height. Come on, 1310. What is the gradient anyway? 101 in 101? Hey! Is the fireman doing some work? Yes, yes. From the line side for a minute. Oh look, there's an ocean liner out there. Looks familiar. Oh, the Poseidon rather than the Leviathan. If I get rid of the HUD for a minute, I might be able to get a nice screenshot actually. Thank you. Oh, we're blowing off. This is good news. Right. Okay, a little bit less coal than the fireman. Oh, yeah. Love super elevation. Need all the power we've got. Come on, little Y7. Is he still shoveling? I told you to stop. Oh, now we're bucking Bronco because we picked up speed. It looks really good on this freight train, doesn't it? I think the first time I'll turn the sound down a little bit. There we go. I think the first time I drove this, I drove the NER 1310 with the inspection saloon, the North Eastern Railway inspection saloon. And it looked really good. Now, if we can reskin this, we can probably turn it into a generic number, member of the class, like something that isn't 1310, or make a few reskins of it. And then you can have a colliery literally just full of these little Y10s. Y10s? Y7s. I don't know why I said Y10s. Y10s are tram engines, aren't they? Are they? I don't know. I know the Y6 was a tram engine, not sure what the Y10 was. I'm sure someone at LNER will tell me in the comments. God, you've done really well. Come on, keep up that boiler pressure. Come on. Coming up to the bridge. So this is where we're going to have to look at the map again. Well, a 1-in-101 still. So, to be fair, I know it's only 5 wagons, but she's done pretty well. All things considered. Considering how small the engine is, these were classed as, like, 0F, I think, by British Railways when they inherited the last couple. The only thing I'd say, maybe, okay, maybe if I'm going to make a suggestion to the developer, I'd say maybe ease off the spark animations for when you're in full regulator. But other than that, I'm finding it difficult to fault this thing, honestly. And that's not me being all, you know, I'm genuinely having trouble finding things wrong with this thing. Hence why I'm still driving it after, how long have I been driving now? An hour! And I've not even finished yet. I still want to go and show you guys the BR version. So let's consult the map and make sure we're going to go up here, up the main. And then when we get up here, we want to stop. Yeah, it's going to take us to the right place anyway. So I think we're coming up to the big bridge. Where we want to pick up a little bit of speed, really. Ooh, bridge. Hang on. Oh, yeah. Let's get across in the bridge. Lovely stuff. In fact, where's my camera? I'm going to move the camera across the watch. Oh, look at it. It's so cute. Ah. Ah. So, I mean, this is a difficulty I'm having nowadays. Trying to do filming for anything. My thumbs are starting to get a bit not good with the Xbox controller. Oh well, I guess it's just part of getting older, I suppose. Could also be the Xbox controller. I could blame my equipment rather than me. It's my equipment that's letting me down, not me, I reckon. Right, have we picked up enough speed? Yes, we picked up enough speed to go up the incline, I reckon. 20 miles an hour. Look at that, on the super elevation. lovely jubbly. And it's nice to sort of come back a little bit. I think that's what I've enjoyed the most. Normally it's just express run down the main line, go as fast as you can. Today it's more just like, let's have a casual little shunt. Or a rough shunt. Depends if you are a rough shunt or not. Now mind me, I know something I haven't done all video. I'm going to do it now quick, just so I don't forget. Right, we do need a bit of water. Sorry everyone, I'll try to, I will try to finish up this stream soon. I promise. I've just been enjoying it. Oh! Okay, never mind. I guess the stream is stopping there because the game dumped on me. Oh, that's a shame. Damn, that's a real shame. Can't keep going, I'm afraid. The game decided to crash on me. That's that doesn't happen very often. Maybe that's the computer telling me that's time to finish this showcase. So, okay then. Thank you, TrainSim, for that. You are fantastic as always. So, slow clap for Train Simulator, everybody. In that case, then, well, I hope you all enjoyed. That does not happen very often. That was great. Trust me though, the BR version is fine. In fact, if you've got Train Sim, go download the Wayside Works Y7 and you can experience it for yourself. And I will most definitely be trying to put that into other scenarios in the future. But that was the Wayside Works LNER Y7, also known as the North Eastern Railway H-Class. Hope you all enjoyed the video, and yeah, I will see you all possibly tomorrow or next time, depending when I decide to do another video. So, thank you all for watching, and I can't believe that happened. At least I didn't crash. I didn't crash. The game crashed me. So, thanks everybody for watching. I'll see you all later, all right? See you later.
It crashed.
Well, that was the line.